high adventure in the wild, vast reaches of space, missions of daring in the name of interplanetary justice. Travel into the future with Buzz Torrey, Commander-in-Chief of the Space Patrol. Brought to you by the Checkerboard Super Cereals, Wheat Chex, Rice Chex, and good hot Ralston.
Lasers, they're playing right across our bow.
Well, they probably tried to contact us, and we don't have a spacer phone.
Stand by for exciting action on The Big Grotius Swindle in just one moment. Checks ring the bell.
I think they're swell. That's what I think about Rice Chex, but say, how about you? What words would you use to tell how good Rice Chex are? Well, when I asked a schoolboy here on Terra to write down for me what he thought about Rice Chex, here's what he showed me. Rice Chex, good to eat and very neat. Rice Chex, just right for a bite.
He's right. Rice Chex has the perfect size for a spoon, the perfect fit for your mouth. Yes, Rice Chex are tops for size. So today, get the cereal your commander goes for, Rice Chex.
Now, when I asked a schoolgirl here on Terra to write down on paper for me what she thought about Rice Chex, here's what she showed me. Rice Chex, the bite-sized cereal that tastes as good as it looks. Yes, sir, looks good, is good. Rice Chex, three times toasted to make it three times as good. Tops for taste, you bet. And say, a nourishing breakfast with Rice Chex is tops for get up and go. A kind of rip-roaring, high-soaring energy that'll help make you a winner in sports and in your studies. And say, Chex come in whole wheat flavor, too. Wheat Chex, bite-sized biscuits spun out of keen-tasting shredded whole wheat. And inside every package of Chex, you get one of those great new free Space Patrol trading cards. Get Chex today. Tops three ways. For size, for taste, for get up and go. Rice Chex. Wheat Chex.
Buzz Corey, Cadet Happy, and Major Robertson have escaped from their cell in the Mercury hideout of Proteus and are hurriedly freeing the other captives, Halifax, Matsung, and Justin, so they can blast off in pursuit of the evil Proteus. Meanwhile, aboard his own ship, headed for Terra, where he can put his ruthless plan of impersonation into effect, is the master of disguise himself, Mr. Proteus. Certain that he has succeeded in doing away with the three space patrolmen and the three industrialists whom he has been impersonating, he deftly applies a disguise. Trained fingers work rapidly to transform Mr. Proteus, the trusted director of the United Planets Fissionable Materials Council, into an exact duplicate of industrialist Henry Halifax. Marco, a trusted assistant, watches, greatly impressed with the amazing transformation that is taking place before his eyes. Then Marco has a sudden thought.
Hey, Mr. Proteus, I know it's not very likely, but what if Corey and the others should escape from their cells?
Marco, you underestimate me.
No, sir, I only mean that we left Corey's ship there. If they should manage to escape, they'll try to beat us back to Terra. Certainly space a phone ahead and warn them.
Exactly. But Marco, if they should, as you suggest, break out of their cells, let me assure you they'll never get any farther than Corey's ship.
It sure does feel good to be back aboard Terra 5 again.
How's Mr. Matsoon holding up, Robbie? I mean the real one.
No, pretty well, sir. Halifax is looking after him. Justin's lying down, too. He'll be all right after a little rest away from that awful heat.
You'd better call the Secretary General and tell him about Proteus.
Smoking rockets, that's right. Well, they don't even know that Proteus is behind this whole deal. I'll make the call for you, sir.
Go ahead.
Hello? phones blew up when Hap switched on.
Proteus.
Yes, he thinks of everything. Happy!
Oh.
Is he all right?
Smoking rockets, I think so. What? That space phone sure talked back to me. And I didn't even say anything to it.
See what the damage is. I'll tell our passengers what the noise is all about.
Yes, sir.
Teenager, now we're really going to have to make tracks. Boy, oh, boy. That Proteus in his disguises. Would I like to get my hands on him? I'd change his appearance.
Explosive charges in the space phone. That's ingenious, Mr. Proteus.
Yes, but you should see what's waiting for them if they should try to fire rockets.
You wired their starter switch, too?
Marco, if they hit that starter lever, our friend Corey and everyone aboard the Terra 5 will be blown to atoms.
Well, that's about all the damage there is, Major. Spacophone's a mess, but it didn't hurt the ship controls. It'll fly, all right.
Okay, then what are we waiting for?
Fire rocket, sir?
Yep, fire rocket, sir.
Happy, hold it!
Huh?
Get your hand off that starter switch.
But, Commander, I was just going to blast off.
I told him to fire rocket, sir. Anything wrong?
Well, I don't know, but what just happened a minute ago?
Well, the spacophone blew up when I flicked the switch.
What do you think might happen if you throw the starter switch?
Well, the whole ship might blow up. Blow up! Smoking rockets, Commander, you don't think the starter switch is gimmick, too?
I'm not sure, but we already know that Proteus is a man who doesn't leave anything to chance. Do you think any reason why he wouldn't rig the starter switch?
It makes sense, all right.
I'll take your word for it.
You'd better go back to the engine room and go over every inch of it.
And I hope we find some explosives, too.
You hope we do?
Well, yes, sir. Then we can disconnect it. But, well, if we don't find any, we'll never be sure that we just didn't miss it. And I don't think my nerves could stand the suspense.
We're approaching Terra now, Mr. Proteus. What's our first move?
Well, first, as director of the Fissionable Materials Commission, I'll make a few spacophone calls to set the wheels in motion. With the special emergency powers the Security Council has granted me, it'll be no trouble to get an authorization to buy power units.
Then, as Mr. Halifax, I will personally accept the money.
Oh. Certainly are clever, Mr. Proteus. You should be Secretary General.
Secretary General? Marco, after we receive the money for Halifax, to say nothing of the Matsung and Justin companies, we'll be able to buy and sell 100 Secretaries General.
The approach warning. We're ready to land on Terra.
On Terra, capital of the United Planet, the feeling of impending disaster is evident in the strange silence that has fallen over Terra City itself. At Buzz's central office at Space Patrol headquarters on Terra, Carol, daughter of the Secretary General, informs her father of a new situation that is developing.
The report just came in, Dad. There must have been 2,000 or 3,000 people. Yes, they tried to force their way inside the Halifax atomic plant. Well, I don't know, but word must have leaked out that Halifax was demanding such a ridiculous price for his stockpile of power units. Oh, no, Dad, Buzz isn't here. Neither is Hap or Robbie. Major Colwell's in charge till they get back. But, Dad, I'm worried. All these riots breaking out and something might have happened to Buzz.
Take a look.
Smoking rockets, Commander. I'm sure glad you stopped me from hitting that starter switch. There's enough explosive here to make dust out of this ship and everybody aboard it.
I'm still wondering whether we found all of it.
So am I, Robbie.
Well, we went over every inch of the engine compartment.
You think we did, Hap, but we can't be absolutely sure without dismantling the whole ship.
Smoking rockets, now you got me worried again. I thought we were all set to blast off after Proteus.
If we don't get Proteus soon, he'll wreck the entire system.
You're right, Robbie. Can't waste another minute. You two get off the ship.
Off the ship?
I thought we were blasting off, sir.
We are. That is, if nothing happens when I throw the starter switch.
When? But, Commander, if we didn't find all the explosive, why, it might blow you and the ship to pieces.
And if the three of us are on board, it'll get us all.
Oh, now look, Commander, I say let's all take our chances together.
Now look, both of you. Security of the entire system depends on our stopping Proteus from carrying out his plan. We're the only ones who know he's behind this.
Well, but, Commander, it...
So we can't afford to take a risk. Take the passengers and yourselves off the ship. If nothing happens, when I throw the starter switch, come back aboard fast and we'll make tracks for Terra.
Well, Commander, let me do it. I'm just a cadet.
No time to argue. Now move on the double.
And a few minutes later, when he is sure the passengers have been removed from the ship, Buzz takes his place in the cockpit of the fast battlecruiser, fully aware that these could be his last moments. Fully aware that if they have failed to find all of the hidden explosive, his next move could result in a tremendous explosion that would reduce the ship to dust and mean the end of the commander-in-chief of the Space Patrol. Grimly, he places his hand on the starter lever.
Tommy, Hatch, back aboard, quick! We're on our way to Terra.
Okay, so let's go.
Yeah, what are we waiting for?
Nothing. Whoa!
Commander Corey's office.
Is that you, Miss Carlisle? This is Mr. Proteus. May I speak with Commander Corey, please?
Well, he isn't here, Mr. Proteus, and I haven't heard from him. In fact, I was hoping you might know where he'd gone.
No, I'm sorry he didn't tell me. But there's something much more urgent to concern ourselves with at the moment. The Security Council has authorized the purchase of the power units from the three companies.
Those prices?
We're faced with a very serious emergency, Miss Carlisle. We must act quickly. Who's in charge in Commander Corey's absence?
Well, Major Colville, he's here right now, but can't we wait until Buzz gets back?
I'm sorry, but minutes count. Please inform Major Caldwell that it's his responsibility to see that the money gets to Mr. Halifax. He's to pick it up at the Terra Bank's main vault. 6 billion credits for 6,000 power units. And tell him to be sure the money is heavily guarded. It's all in cash.
6 billion credits in cash?
Yes, it was necessary to drain the cash reserves of the entire system to make the 6 million, plus 4 billion for Matsung and 2 billion for the Justin Company. But the first delivery is to Henry Halifax himself.
Oh, this is outrageous.
I know how you must feel about it, Miss Carlisle, but there's nothing we can do about it. And there's no time to talk about it further. Please see that Major Caldwell gets on the job immediately. Proteus out. You see, Marco, how easy it is without Corey around to get in my hair?
Oh, you mean in Mr. Halifax's hair, don't you?
How are we doing? Smoking rockets. We just had a space phone. We could call ahead and warn them about Proteus.
If we'd have got on the outer hull with our miniature space hull, they wouldn't have enough range to do us any good.
Yeah, Proteus has had time to get to Terra already.
He's probably putting his plan into effect by now.
Come in, come in. And move lively, I'm a very busy man.
Put the money here on the desk, men. Then stand guard outside.
Is it all here? 6 billion in cash?
I can assure you, Mr. Halifax, but I'm not going to wait till you count it. Sign this.
Hey, fellas and girls, you know who this is? He started flying at the age of 15, and now he's a well-known record-breaking aviator. This is Tony LeVere, test pilot on the Starfire, the famous jet plane assigned to the vital mission of defending our homeland. But let's watch Tony make a test flight right now. Okay, come in, Tony LeVere.
Here's the Starfire, the Air Force Interceptor F-94C, designed by the Lockheed Aircraft Corporation, Burbank, California. Packing 48 rockets, the radar-controlled Starfire can take off, find the enemy, and attack day or night. Speed, more than 600 miles per hour.
Hello, I'm Tony LeVere, test pilot of the Starfire. Now I'd like to show you how we make a quick stop on a short runway. Boy, it's sure a good feeling for a pilot to have that parachute pop out and slow down his plane like that. You know, good health is important to a test pilot, and I have to stay in top condition. I get lots of rest and eat plenty of good food. That's why I like a good cereal for breakfast, like Rice Chex or Wheat Chex. They have real energy, and they taste swell. Why don't you try them?
No other cereal, popped or flaked, contains so much nourishment in such concentrated bite-sized form. Rice Chex, Wheat Chex. Get some at your grocer's today.
Make sure you keep yourself ready for action the way Tony LeVere, Bob Love, Phil Houghton, and lots of other famous test pilots do. Eat Rice Chex and Wheat Chex every morning. The cereals that are tops three ways. For taste, for size, for get up and go. That's Chex, rice or wheat. Now back to Space Patrol.
There you are. Well, you may leave. You have no further business here.
You must be very proud of yourself, you traitor.
Get out of this office before I have you thrown out.
Don't start anything you can't finish, Halifax.
Take your filthy hands off me. I know my rights as a citizen.
Your rights as a citizen. The word citizen and the name Halifax should never be mentioned in the same breath.
Well...
I gather that she doesn't think very much of Mr. Halifax.
Everything went very smoothly, sir.
Yes, Marco.
Hardly a hitch.
One down and two to go.
Whom do you impersonate next?
Matsoon.
Ah.
We must hurry to get to Venus so I can appear as the...
Honorable Mr. Matsoon. I received the 4 billion credits for his power unit.
Major... I'm going to Venus with you to take the money to Matsoon. It's hard to believe there could be another man in the system as low as Halifax. But if there is, I want to see him.
Take over, Hannah.
We may as well face it, Commander. We'll never get back to Terra in time to keep Proteus from getting the money from Halifax's power units.
Yeah, and then he'll skip out, and the next thing we know, he'll pull up the Matsoon deal on Venus.
Why didn't I think of that before?
Think of what, sir?
What's our position now, Hap?
Well, we're still a long way from Terra, Commander. We just passed Venus a little while ago. Venus, I get it.
You could be waiting for him there at Matsoon's office.
I'll bring the ship about.
So there's a ship out there, a Space Patrol ship.
That is a break. Hap.
Yes, sir?
Get into a spacesuit as fast as you can. Go in the outer hull and contact that ship with your suit spacephone. They can relay the information about Proteus.
I'm practically outside right now, sir.
I'll pull alongside.
What a beautiful sight.
Major, there's no doubt about it. That is Commander Corey's ship. Calling Commander Corey aboard Terra 5. Come in, please. Buzz, this is Carol. Do you read me? Major, they're bearing down on us. Buzz, this is Carol. Do you read me? There could only be one answer to this, Major. Someone else must be in command of Buzz's ship. They're trying to get closer to us. Maybe they know we're carrying all that money.
Order them to stand off 10 DUs or we'll fire.
Space cruiser T-26 to Terra 5. Stand off 10 DUs or we'll fire. Major, they're still coming.
Flying across our bow.
Probably trying to contact us, and we don't have a spacer phone. Happy, hurry up.
I'm hurrying, sir.
Hey, use asking for it. Better pull away a little bit so they won't think we're trying to attack them.
They're coming about and pulling away. Well, that settles it. There is something wrong on that ship. We're going after them, Major. I'm going to fire on target.
Come on, happy boy. Hurry, hurry.
Well, here it goes, and this time I won't miss.
Terra 5 to Space Patrol Ship T-26. Cadet Happy speaking. Hold your fire.
See, and I almost blew that ship up.
I'm contacting you with a suit space remote from the outer hull. Our long-range equipment is out of order.
Happy, this is Carol.
Carol? What are you doing out here? I'm on my way to meet Mr. Major Caldwell to take the money to the Mattoon Company. Is Buzz all right? Sure. He and Major Robertson are aboard the ship. And boy, will they be glad to know it's you. We were headed for Mattoon's office on Venus 2. Now we can all go together.
I better hurry and get into the disguise of Mattoon before they get here with the money.
I wonder who that could be.
I'll answer and find out.
Mr. Mattoon's office. Yes. They're here already. The Major, the girl, and the money.
Have them come in. I can still make an appearance as Mattoon.
Mr. Mattoon says, have them come in.
Put those right down over there, close to the wall.
Mr. Mattoon will be with you in a moment. I must ask you to wait, however.
Who says we have to wait?
Put that back on.
Oh, yes, sir.
All right, Commander, you can come in now.
Corey!
Well, Mr. Proteus, delighted to see you again.
How did you do it? How did you do it?
Well, that's a long story, Proteus, but you're going to have a long time to hear it.
The light!
Watch, Proteus!
Better, Proteus disappeared.
Hap, hang on to this one.
Got him, Dad.
We've got to get Proteus before he gets out of the building.
I think you'll have to admit, Marco.
I'm still a master of disguise.
Mr. Proteus. Come, now's our chance. We'll get out the back way. And Marco, we still have all the Halifax money. I think we'll be able to get along on 6 billion credits, don't you?
I was going to ask you, what happened after I left you here to guard Marco?
Me, sir? I don't know. I don't remember anything after I got caught right after the lights went out.
The lights went out? That means Proteus was here all the time.
Yeah.
I left Marco with him.
Look, Commander, at least Proteus can't do any more damage.
Now that the real Halifax, Matsung, and Justin are back at their business, they'll be able to produce all the power units the system needs.
Yes, Robbie, that's one problem solved. But Proteus is still at large, and he has 6 billion credits that belong to the United Planets.
Yeah, and he's not going to be very easy to find, either.
I'll have to admit he's a master of disguise.
Yeah. You know, that character could be standing right next to you, and you wouldn't even recognize him.
Come on, Marco.
Yes, Mr. Proteus.
Say, wait for Mr. Matsung. Huh?
In just a moment, a preview of next week's exciting Space Patrol adventure, which will be brought to you by Nestle's Ever Ready, the instant cocoa, and famous Nestle's chocolate bar. Well, Space Patrollers, we can't tell you how the commander and Hap are going to solve this big problem, but there's one thing you can be sure of. They'll be calling for plenty of Nestle's Ever Ready cocoa to help them with their figuring. Fellas and girls, Nestle's Ever Ready Cocoa is one of the greatest tasting energy builders you can have. It's a delicious hot chocolate drink full of rich whole milk and sugar. It's got what you need for strong, healthy bodies and keen, alert minds. And nothing could be easier than making some Nestle's Ever Ready Cocoa all by yourself. All you do is put in 1, 2, 3 teaspoons in your cup, add hot water, and there you have it. Space Patrollers, Nestle's Ever Ready Cocoa is the standard Space Patrol mealtime drink. And between meals, too. So be sure to ask Mom to bring home the big red and yellow can of Nestle's Ever Ready Cocoa. Remember,
N-E-S-T-L-E-S. Nestle's makes the very best chocolate.
Scene from next week's exciting adventure, The Escape of Mr. Proteus.
I'm listening.
And listen closely, Commander. Major Robertson is my prisoner. What's more, he's hidden where you'll never find him. Now get this. If you ever want to see him alive, again, these are my terms. You'll guarantee safe passage out of this building and off Venus for Marco and me and the money. Well, speak up, Corey. Major Robertson's life depends on your answer.
Be sure to see what happens when Buzz is faced with a decision which could cost Robbie his life when he tries to prevent the escape of Mr. Proteus next week on Space Patrol. Was brought to you today by the bite-sized cereals in the red and white checkerboard packages. Wheat Chex and Rice Chex. Be sure to hear Space Patrol on ABC Radio every Saturday. Consult your newspaper for time and station.